With macOS Sonoma, Apple introduced Presenter Overlay. With Presenter Overlay, when you are sharing your screen, what participants are able to do is not only see you, but they can also see the screen that you are sharing at the same time. Now, the way that this works is through sharing your screen. The presenter needs to share their screen, which means that, for the most part, any app that you can share your screen with is going to be able to use Presenter Overlay. This includes Zoom. This includes FaceTime. I'm going to show you or demonstrate how this works with Zoom, because I believe that's how most people will be using it. Let's take a look at how Presenter Overlay works with Zoom on the Mac with macOS Sonoma. Now, as I mentioned, I'm going to be demonstrating this through Zoom. So I have a MacBook Air here where I'm signed into Zoom. I'm hosting a meeting. I'm given a presentation. I want to share my screen. Now, all I need to do is just click on Share My Screen. But before I do, I also want to show you that I do have an iPad connected as a guest. So this guest here is going to be able to watch. So we can see it from both the host or the presenter's standpoint as well as the guest. So let's go back over to my MacBook Air and see how this works. As I mentioned, we need to share our screen. So first thing I do is I click on Share Screen. Let's go ahead and click on it. And I'm just going to click on Desktop. I'm going to share my desktop here. So now I'm sharing my desktop. Let's go ahead and hide Zoom here. So I'm sharing my desktop. Now this is nothing new. I'm not using Presenter Overlay at all yet. If I go over to my iPad, you're going to see that I can see my desktop. I go and add a new window on my MacBook Air. Well, if we go over to my iPad, I can see that window. I close the window on my MacBook Air, it closes it. Again, nothing new. I'm not seeing my Presenter Overlay. But now, when I go back over to my MacBook Air, being that I'm using macOS Sonoma, you're going to see that we have a new icon here. This new icon is where we can turn on Presenter Overlay. So now I just click on that as the presenter, and you're going to see I have a couple of options, actually three options, because I can turn it off. I have Presenter Overlay off. It is off right now. This is why it is just standard screen sharing. But also what I have here is small. It's going to put me small in the corner. And then the desktop is going to be large. Or I can reverse that and have me be large. And then the desktop is going to be behind me small. So those are my two different options here. So let's go ahead and take a look at large first. So when I click on this, you're going to see that nothing changed. What happened? Well, when we go over to the guest, you're going to see that they see this presenter overlay. As the host, as a presenter, you do not see this presenter overlay. But as a guest, take a look. They see me large, and I can be like, this is my desktop here. I'm going to open up a new window. There it is. I'm going to close that window. And there it is. Now it's closed. That is the presenter overlay. But again, when we look at it on the Mac, it doesn't look any different. Let's take a look at this with the small overlay. We go back up to our little blue icon in the menu bar. And then we go over to small. And when I do, you can see that I have here an overlay in the lower left-hand corner. Now, they do show this to the presenter, and I'll show you why. First of all, let's take a look at this from the iPad. When I go to the iPad, we can see that we have my icon there. So now when I open up a new window on my Mac, we can see that my overlay is there. I close it, it goes away. Now, why do they show this on the MacBook Air to the presenter? Well, that's because it can cover up things. Let's go ahead and open up that new window. And let's say that this overlay is up towards the top. We can move it. We just drag and drop to move it around. And I want to demonstrate the buttons, the red, yellow, green buttons for closing windows or managing windows. Well, my overlay is over top of it. So this is why they are showing it. They want to show you where that overlay is. So if it's covering something that you're trying to demonstrate, all you have to do is just go and click and drag it to move it to a different location. So now it's over there and I can go and demonstrate what these buttons do. I want to move it back. I just take it and move it back. And again, when we go over to my iPad, we can see that any changes I make are shown directly to that iPad. To turn it off, we just go back over to our MacBook Air And then we go up to our blue icon again, and then we go to off. And when I turn it off, what it's going to do is make it just standard screen sharing. So now I'm not using any overlay. If we go over to the iPad here, it is just straight standard screen sharing. And again, the key to making this all work is you do need to share your screen. So you need to use this with an app that you can share your screen with. Obviously, we can see that Zoom works well with it. FaceTime works well with it. And with FaceTime, you can actually share your window, you can share an app, or you can share your desktop. So you do have a few more options with FaceTime. So depending on which app you have, you're going to have different options up here under this blue button on what you want to share. With Zoom, all we can do is just set it if we want to use small or large. So that is our presenter overlay. Again, the key to making this work is you need to share your screen. So it works basically with any app that you can share your screen with. Share your screen and then look in the menu bar for that blue button. And then when you click on that blue button where you're sharing your screen, if that app supports presenter overlay, you're going to see the options for going with small, large, or even more options such as sharing your window, your screen, or sharing an app. So that is how Presenter Overlay works with macOS Sonoma.